Once I loved such a shattering physician, quite the best looking doctor in the state. He looked after my physical condition, and his bedside manner was great. He said my bronchial tubes were entrancing, my epiglottis filled him with glee. He simply loved my larynx and went wild about my pharynx, but he never said he loved me. He said my epidermis was darling and found my blood as blue as can be. He went through wild ecstatics when I showed him my lymphatics, but he never said he loved me. And though no doubt it was not very smart of me, I kept on a wrecking my soul to figure out why he loved every part of me and yet not me as a whole. With my esophagus he was ravished, enthusiastic to a degree. He said was just enormous my appendix vermiformis, but he never said he loved me. He said my cerebellum was brilliant and my cerebrum filled him with glee. He know he thought a lot of my medulla oblongata, but he never said he loved me. He said my maxillaries were marvels and found my sternum stunning to see. He did a double hurdle when I shook my pelvic girdle, but he never said he loved me. He seemed amused when at first he made a study to further his medical art, yet he refused to fix up the rest of me and cure that ache in my heart. I know he thought my pancreas perfect and for my spleen was keen as could be. He said of all his sweeties I'd the sweetest diabetes, but he never said he loved me. He said my vertebrae were silchona. He called my coccyx plus plus gentil. He cried molto bella when he sat on my patella, but he never said he loved me. He took a fleeting look at my thorax and started singing slightly off key. He cried may heaven strike us when I played my umbilicus, but he never said he loved me. As it was dark, I suggested we walk about before he returned to his post. Once in the park, I induced him to talk about the thing I wanted the most. He lingered on with me until dawn, and when I tried to pay him his fee, he said, "Why don't be funny? It is I who owe you money," but he never said.